My name is Michael Vanderplu. I am an assistant principal here at Table Cape Primary School on the northwest coast of Tasmania. As well as being an assistant principal, I'm also teaching science for 2 days a week. So I teach science from prep to grade six with robotics. This was a grade six focus, and we were looking at the curriculum of digital technologies, and we were looking at programming and getting robots to do a set activity or a set of instructions. And we were focusing mainly on duration and speed. They've worked with robots now for 3 or 4 years, and basically they are now exploring, really nearly independently, some of these challenges that are on offer. So welcome to robotics. We're going to learn, we're going to pull all the things that we've learnt from last year into an activity, okay? So today's intention, learning intention, is to understand how duration and steering can help navigate an NXT robot around a given object. The challenge today is called around the world. And we want your robots to start on this line, travel up to the world, go around the world without hitting it, because that would be a bit messy, and then come back to this line, okay? Now, if you can do that, the challenge will be to do it as quickly as possible. It's all about their estimation skills, their way of trying to solve that problem through the use of duration in a move block, and the way that they use the steering. Way you go, guys. Good luck. I modelled what I wanted to see, and then it was for them to then explore that program and explore the ways to move it. So what can you see? What can you see that needs to improve? Montana? You probably need to go probably a little bit faster, but also it started turning way too early, so that duration needs to be longer. Yep.
Particularly with this lesson, I was really just a guide. I was just there questioning them, seeing if they understood, or if they were a bit lost. What could they do to improve it? What could they do to make that challenge complete?
That is a really nice turn, Montana. Okay, so we've got the duration right. I reckon we've got the turn right, but it bumped into the world. So what's going to happen? Well, how are you going to solve that? Where did you start on the line? Where do you reckon you should start? This is that one. Well done, Amy. Amy, the second challenge is to speed it up now. We want a quick time. Nice one. An improvement. Can anyone see an improvement? Just a slight improvement. Aaliyah?
Make it longer so it goes over the line.
Yeah, make it a little bit longer so it reaches that line. And Dylan, did you see how it went off on an angle? How could you make it so it's straight
make
back?
Make the turn longer.
Make the turn a fraction longer. So see if you can improve it that way.
I really promote that self-evaluation and that self thinking, that critical thinking about their program and or their work and their learning. And it's really important for kids to express that, to talk about that, to not be afraid to say, oh well, I've made a mistake.
In a real world situation, how could this be handy? A robot has to go up to a certain thing, has to turn around it and come back.
And then it goes underwater or something.
Yeah, okay. So you're looking at robots that go underwater. They have to go and search for something. They have to go and find something. They might have to take pictures of going around and then coming back. Yeah.
With the conclusion, we got it back to a focus of real world. We got it back to a focus of community. We made sure that they understood that this type of programming could be used. A lot of those students had a little bit of difficulty interpreting that. It's something that I might need to work on a little bit more with that group.
What could be the next challenge? What could be something that we could do next? Something that's a little bit more advanced, something a little bit different. What could we do next, Amy?
Go around it twice.
And I think that's an exciting way of teaching, where you have the kids thinking about the next step.